I'm Alex, and
I'm Nora.
And we're part of Edward Sharpe and the Magnetic Zeros.
One of the really amazing things about having such a large band is there's so many different influences and education levels. Some people are trained jazz musicians, some people went to trained in Africa, you know, for drumming and rhythm, and some of us kind of taught ourselves what we know or picked up pieces here along the way. So I think when we all come together, it offers not just one school of thought or one approach to playing or learning music, but everyone kind of throws in a different color into the pot, I'd say.
I think that the pressure at the beginning, because it wasn't like we had this machine of like a giant label funding us or anything, so there was sort of this this meeting point of dream and reality that was a little nerve-wracking in some ways, and you really had to have faith that it was gonna work. I bought a bus on Craigslist, and we went to South by Southwest, and it was really this sort of make-or-break, bizarre situation. And now I think that there's been, you know, as you say, success with the album and with home and with all that. We have come to understand like how appreciative these people are of the whole thing. The essence maybe that they got from home, I think, is in some ways more important to them than the song. It's not that I came up with an alter ego or anything called Edward Sharpe. It was just a story I was writing where the character was Edward Sharpe. It sort of got lost in translation. There's sort of no character that I'm playing or an alter ego, really, but more something that I think I'm reaching towards within myself, maybe, or that we all are.